We'll look at how to add transitions and animations to a video. First, transitions. Let's look at our video with transitions added. By comparing these two videos, we can see how adding transitions makes the change from one clip or scene to another much more natural. Now, let's learn how to add a transition. In the editor, you can see that there is a small white block with a black bar that connects two clips. Tap the white block to bring up the transitions menu. CapCut provides different categories of transitions, including basic, camera, effect, and more. For each transition, there is also a preview GIF, so you can see what it looks like. Tap a transition, and then tap the check mark to apply it between two clips of your video. Once it's applied, you'll see that the black bar has changed into a double triangle icon, and that the straight split line has turned into a diagonal line. We can also see the transition in the preview. Back in the transition menu, we can set how long the transition takes by moving the circle along the duration slider. Move the circle left to shorten the transition, and move it right to lengthen the transition. Generally, it works best when the duration of the transition matches the music. If the music is slow, the transition should be longer. If you want to change to another transition, just tap another transition and it will be replaced. If you want to remove the transition, just tap the None button on the far left. To add the same transition to all the clips, tap Apply to All. While transition effects can make transitions smoother, it is not always a matter of the more the better. Don't let transitions get in the way of your story. Now, let's look at another powerful effect, animations. Let's add animations to our video to see how it looks. From this example, we can see that animations add movement to the video. In CapCut, we can add animations to text and stickers, as well as the video itself. First, let's look at how we can add an animation to a clip. Tap a clip, and then find Animation in the bottom toolbar. You'll see three options: In, Out, and Combo. In applies the animation to the start of the clip. Tap In to see the animations. It's easy to add one. Simply tap the animation and then tap the check mark. You can see that the start of the clip now has some color shading, which shows where the animation is. We can also preview the animation to see how it looks. If we want to change how long the animation lasts, we can move the circle on the duration slider. Move it left to shorten the animation, or move it right to lengthen it. If you don't like how it looks, tap the None button to the left of the animation GIFs. The Out animation adds an animation to the end of the clip, and the Combo animation adds both In and Out animations. You can add and edit them in the same way as the In animation. One thing to note, though, is that the Combo animation applies to the whole of a clip. Generally, we use an In animation for the first clip in a video and an Out animation for the last clip in a video. For middle clips, we'll use a transition. But it's really up to you. Next, we'll look at text animations. Tap the Text button in the toolbar and then tap the Animation button. Here, you can see three types of text animation: In, Out, and Loop. Let's focus on the loop animation. The effect is added to the entire text track, and it can't be used in conjunction with the In and Out animations. The slider underneath Loop is used to change the animation speed, not the duration, as you can see here. Last, sticker animations. These work the same way as text animations, so we won't go over how to use them here. Why not try them for yourself? That's all for this lesson. The next lesson is the last in the series, and we'll go over how to set a cover and export your video. See you there!